Drew and Josie's story began 3 years ago at a New Year's Eve party, in which Drew followed Josie around most of the night, obviously very keen to know her, and even persuaded her to catch an Uber. Now, I know this sounds a little creepy, but everyone that knows Drew knows he wears his heart on his sleeve and he wouldn't hurt a fly. Lucky for Drew, his manliness was enough to melt Josie's heart. And it didn't take her very long to fall head over heels in love with him.
I had no idea that when I met you at Jai's party on New Year's Eve, that I'd be here today becoming your full-time lover. Josie, you are the mustard on my snag of bread. You're the Pepsi in my Captain Morgan. And you're the cheese on my pizza. You're the water to my ocean and the music to my ears. You are the question mark at the end of my question. You are the love of my life.
Drew, my love, my rock, my best friend. You came into my life exactly at the right time, when I wasn't ready, and yet when I needed your love the most. You're the most amazing man, partner, and best friend. You were thoughtful, you're silly, and you're smart and contagious. And you managed to keep me and all my personalities grounded. From you bringing me home weeds from the forestry thinking they were flowers, to always offering me the first sip of your beer. But nothing screams he's the one more than when he buys you a Dyson vacuum only weeks into seeing each other.
I promise to always keep you warm on those cold nights, like I've got no choice. I promise that my next fish tank will only be double the size of the last one. I promise. And I promise to love you unconditionally for five ever, because forever is not long enough. Josie, I love you more today than I did yesterday, and every tomorrow I'll love you more than I did the day before.
I'm so grateful I get to experience this thing called life with you by my side. The ups, the downs, and the sideways, I know we can conquer anything that is thrown at us as long as we have each other. I can't wait to fill our future with love, laughter, and most of all, adventure. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow, always.
I would have the absolute honour of pronouncing, is that slow enough? Of pronouncing you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
So, even before you guys were planning this wedding, Ashton and I always called you Arnie Jokes. We knew you would be the one. You are the best. You're my Arnie Jokes. Come here.
Josie calls herself our miracle child. So our miracle child came home one day and said, Mum, I've been seeing this guy called Drew. He's covered in tats, Mum, and he's not really what I go for. She said, he's a bit rough around the edges, but he's really nice, and I think Dad will like him because he really talks a lot. So, Drew, I would like to welcome you into our family officially. We love you dearly. You have a huge heart. You're a big softie, and you give the best hugs. You really do give the best hugs. You still talk the hind leg of a donkey, though. So welcome to family. I wish you all the best for the future.
Josie, you have been my sister, my best friend, my rock, my therapist, my everything in between, and I cannot think of anyone else I would call. If anything happened, happy, sad, nothing, I will call you. Drew, you are definitely the more affectionate one out of both of you. Josie would never hug me, even if I was dying. But you are definitely my big bear cuddle, and I cannot be happier to now officially call you my family. You are my rock, as well as Josie. You are a good person, and I'm so glad you brought Josie's happiness.
Given that you're both committing the rest of your lives together, Lloyd and I thought it was timely to keep it a bit real. Josie Ann, frankly, there'll be times when you want to throttle Drew. And Drew, there'll be times when you want to kick Josie up the bum. But there'll also be times when you'll miss each other. Therefore, we have something for both of you that may help you release that anger without exerting the physical brutality you may feel at times, but also to cuddle when you feel you need. So cuddle them, kiss them, throw them, poke them, throttle them, they can take it all.
Yeah, so we're all here tonight, whether they like you or your family. So one or the other, we're here. Drew, I'm not going to sit here and tell stories about Drew. He's my best mate. And as much as we'd walk to school and tell each other we hated each other and wanted to kill each other and that, we're best mates. I moved away for a couple of years and I missed him dearly. Let's just raise a hand to the newest Mrs. and Mrs. Arnold.
So she's never on time for anything. When she gets that come get me look in her eyes, well, it kinda scares me the way that she drives me wild. And she drives me wild. Take chances and wears her heart on her sleeve. Yeah, she's crazy, but her crazy